Hello students, how are you all? I expect all of you are fine. I am also fine. Thank you. After closing our online class for 8 and 10, we are going to start for class 6, 7 and 9. So, welcome to my online class. Let's start our class. Learners, can you say, where do people go to say their prayers? Or where do you go to say your prayers? Yes, people go to mosque to say their prayer, and you would also go. Okay, am I right? Thank you. So, what's our lesson today? Can you guess? Yes, today is our lesson, the Shat Gumbuz Mosque. Today is our lesson, Unit A. Lesson 1. This class is for 9. Learners, before beginning our lesson, let's know some learning outcomes. After we have studied this text, we will be able to listen for specific information, read and understand text, infer meaning from the context, ask and answer questions. Learners, open your book. Section A. Look at the picture. Everybody, look at the picture. Okay? Look at the picture. Talk about the picture and ask and answer the following question. Here are some questions for you. What is this building? Look at the picture. What is this building? Oh, this is a nice building of mosque. Okay. Do you have a building like this in your town or village? Yes, you have a building like this in your village. But not so many domes. Am I right? Okay. What do we call it? What do we call it? We call it mosque. What is it used for? It is used for saying prayers. Okay? Learners, before beginning our lesson, let's know some new vocabulary. Have a look at this. Some new vocabs for you. Heritage. Heritage means features belonging to the culture of a particular place. Features belonging to the culture of a particular place. Inspiration. Inspiration, someone or something that gives you ideas for doing something. Okay. Our next word, indicate. To suggest something. To suggest something. Inherit. To receive something from someone after they have died. Inherit means to receive something from someone after they have died. Okay? Learners, at first I would like to read the text. The first three parts of this text. And then I'll ask you question. Section B. Heritage is what we inherit from the past, live with in the present and then pass on to our children or future generation. Our unique source of life and inspiration is our culture and natural heritage. When we speak of world heritage, it indicates places and sites that we inherited from the past and pass on to the future generation of the entire world. Next, The Shah Gumbuz Mosque in Bagerhat is such a heritage. It became a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1985. Originally, the historic mosque city was known as Holy Fatabad. It is situated at the outskirts of Bagerhat town, not very far from the dense mangrove forest of the Sundarbans. Holy Fatabad was a Muslim colony. It was founded by the Originally, the historic mosque city was known as Holy Fatabad. It is situated at the outskirts of Bagerhat town, not very far from the dense mangrove forest of the Sundarbans. Holy Fatabad was a Muslim colony. It was founded by the Turkish general, a saint warrior, Ulu Khan Jahan, in the 15th century. The infrastructure of the city reveals significant technical skills in many mosques as well as early Islamic monuments. Big bricks were used for the construction of the buildings. The planning of the city was dominated by the tradition of Islamic architecture, and the decorations were a combination of Mughal and Turkish architecture. Learners, now I'll ask you a question. Here are some questions for you. Number one, what does World Heritage indicate? What does World Heritage indicate? World Heritage indicates places and sites that we inherited from the past and pass on to the future generation of the entire world. Okay? What does World Heritage indicate? World Heritage indicates places and sites that we inherited from the past and pass on to the future generation of the entire world. Okay? Do you agree with me? Now, second question. By whom and where was a Muslim colony founded? By whom and where was a Muslim colony founded? A Muslim colony was founded by Ulu Khan Jahan Ali. A Muslim colony was founded by Ulu Khan Jahan Ali in Bagerhat. Okay? Our next question. Where does the Shah Gumbuz Mosque stand? Where does the Shah Gumbuz Mosque stand? The Shah Gumbuz Mosque stands at the outskirts of Bagerhat town. Do you agree with me? Thank you. Our next question. When was the Muslim colony founded in Bagerhat? When was the Muslim colony founded in Bagerhat? The Muslim colony was founded in Bagerhat in the 15th century. Okay? Do you agree with me? Now, learners, what do you learn from the three parts of this text? What do you learn? Learners, heritage indicates places and sites that we inherited from the past and pass on to the future generation of the entire world. Shah Gumbuz Mosque is such a heritage. It became a UNESCO World Heritage in the year of 1985. Ulu Khan Jahan Ali, a great saint warrior, was founded the Muslim colony in the 15th century. The planning of the city was dominated by the tradition of Islamic architecture, and decorations were a combination of Mughal and Turkish architecture. Okay, do you agree with me? Learners, now your homework. Here are some clues for you. Heritage, generation, unique, entire, Muslim colony, infrastructure, decoration. By using these clues, you will make a paragraph. It's your homework. Okay? This is the end of my class. Learners, see you next day. So, stay home, stay safe. Goodbye.